A crisis on the border and a crisis in the community. A renewed outbreak of the deadly COVID-19 virus in the Gaza Strip, which has killed four people so far, as humanitarian workers struggle to provide care within a crumbling healthcare system.
Any health item or related material that you can imagine necessary to counter the COVID pandemic is needed. It's the laboratory materials, protective equipment. Even just 2 days ago, even we donated bed mattresses for hospitals and bed linens for hospitals.
The full range of services to people infected all the way through to ICU, intensive care. We only have 97 beds in, right now available in Gaza, and about two-thirds of those are currently being used for regular patients. So we have to expand that capacity quite dramatically in case things go to the worst-case scenario, and that's where our biggest fear at the moment.
The Strip has largely avoided a major outbreak of the pandemic by creating quarantine centers at the major crossings where health officials screened and isolated COVID cases. But last week brought their worst nightmare, community spread.
Because it's now in the community, we can only imagine it will spread.
Now there are close to 400 reported cases, which is expected to rise, in one of the most densely populated areas on Earth. 2 million people living in just 365 square kilometers. As security tension amplifies humanitarian needs, fire balloons launched by militants in Gaza sparked more than 400 fires in southern Israel in recent weeks. In response, Israel tightened the blockade, blocking fuel entry for Gaza's only power plant, leaving residents with just 3 to 4 hours of power per day.
Big hospitals like Indonesia and Shifa Nasser, they are having electricity cuts of only 1 hour per day. But there are the smaller hospitals that go through 20, 16, 19, or 13 hours of electricity cuts. So that is really unbearable for a health system.
All those clinics that we mentioned, the quarantine centers and the isolation centers, all require electricity to keep functioning. It was 39 degrees yesterday, so, I mean, these places are not easy to live in when it's not your home and you've got no electricity there, not a normal life. And so the pressure on you and on the people providing services is great.
I mean, we're in Gaza today. It is a very hot and humid day, like it is in Ashkelon, Tel Aviv, and regular household cannot even connect a fan.
As the region enters a blistering heat wave with temperatures set to soar and tension on the border continuing to rise, the people of Gaza plummet into a crisis within a crisis. Emily Rose, I-24 News.